Recently, I had pleasure to read article about upcoming Nintendo Switch port of Kingdom Come, Deliverance, and they call it Nintendo Switch Remaster. Sadly, I don't have Link anymore, but this made me slightly irritated. Surely, I cannot be only one bothered with fact how gaming journalists and YouTubers are using these words loosely. For example, I saw multiple articles referring to Diablo 2 Remake as Diablo 2 Remaster. Or it's Remaster, I am just wrong. Oh, it's truly Remaster. Well, now, this is getting confusing. But you see, this rapid misuse of words can set wrong expectation. And yet, practically no one cares. So, to fight this recent trend, let's simply define what these words mean. Let's start, for example, with re-release. Well, this one is simple. Game was once released and was selling, and for whatever reason it stopped selling, so it's getting released again. Usually they are old classic games, released on physical media, are getting released at digital distribution services. Great example of re-releases is platform GOG that is selling many practically forgotten games. Actually, GOG started with this purpose to sell old games that were nowhere available. GOG often offers some services like upgrades that make this game playable on modern PCs, and some of these upgrades are bigger and could be, for example, classified as remasters. For example, you can buy First Diablo with add-on on GOG, game that was really long forgotten and, well, not forgotten, but nowhere available to buy. Next one is port. Porting is process of converting game for platform that was not originally designed for. During 7th console generation there were some notoriously bad PC ports from Xbox 360, most notably Grand Theft Auto 4, Saints Row 2, or Dark Souls. In present days, Nintendo Switch ports became really popular, for example Witcher 3, which is one of the most impressive Nintendo Switch ports. Well, they recently announced Kingdom Come Deliverance for Switch, which inspired me to make this video, and I frankly cannot imagine it on Switch since it's so demanding game. Ports often have some changes to original game to make it playable on different platforms that has perhaps different control schemes or some PC ports of console games usually have graphics settings somewhat better graphics than their console counterparts, and unlocked frame rate. Or they don't do anything and just release lazy port from console that is not playable on keyboard and mouse. And now, finally, meat of this video, remasters. Remastering is act of modernizing original art pieces while using original assets. You can see that in music where old songs get new digital releases, or old movies that are mastered again from source and upscaled with high resolution or get new color grading. In video games, act of remastering is a little bit more difficult. Most of remasters are using original code base engine or original art, and then start building. Or don't then just sell game from last generation in higher resolution or higher frame rate. In early PS4 and Xbox days, we saw plenty of remasters that were simply ports of original games in higher resolution. The thing is, remasters can really differ in quality. Sometimes lazy ports sold as remaster is less evil than developers of ports start changing things without knowing what they are doing. Look at Warcraft 3 Reforged. That removes some features of original release and it's overall just inferior product. Or when Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition was released, they bring new content and cutscenes that kinda change feel of the game. Not to count, it was released quite buggy. In present day, most of these bugs are fixed, but it still irks some people that they have to buy remasters to get original titles in present day. That's another trouble with remasters. The listing of original games from sale, so you can buy more expensive remasters. Some studio decided to make original releases as part of remaster collection, so you have to buy a remaster to get original game. And some simply not sell original game. Well, I talk negatively about many aspects of remasters, but there are many positive ones. Let's, for example, count some really good remasters. For example, recent Mass Effect trilogy or Shadow of Colossus remasters are examples of remasters done right. They respect original titles, but modernize them, make graphics more crisp, and are a good choice for fans or new audiences. Saints Row 3 is another example of remasters that change graphics sustainably, but and some people don't like new faces, but it's really well done. Some people even call it small remake. Oh, and speaking of remakes, well, Remake is right in the world. Remake. In movie industry, live action remakes of old animated classic from Disney became notorious. In video games, remakes are older titles rebuilt from zero in new engine with new technology to resemble, say, older classics. Since original code and assets are mostly not used, while doing process of remaking, you have to create everything from the ground to resemble original title. Or not and change everything and instead just try to capture feeling and story of it. Original. For example, Final Fantasy VII Remake. Actually, Final Fantasy VII Remake changed story. So, it's not perhaps greatest example. Well, it can be quite nostalgic play old title with new code of pain. For example, Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy. When I played it for first time, it's a really faithful recreation of original three games in the new engine. And it's great. Remakes are hard. On one hand, you try to get new audience. On hand other, you don't want to alienate fans of original work. One of example of terrible mistakes is XEE, which is Roman numerals for 13. Original is beloved cult classic shooter, known for its unique cel shading art style and great story, with using comic-like fondant panels. Well, Remake completely kill original style, with more realistic but totally inconsistent graphics, and shockingly worse gameplay than original titles. And some remakes even use original codebase and import it into new engines, for example like Demon's Souls Remaster. That one is great. Remakes are kinda safe way for developers to sell games. And lastly, reimagination or reboot. When game developers get tired, well, market gets tired of the way series going, developers can try reimagining entire series with new mechanics, art style, setting or gameplay. Prince of Persia was rebooted many times, like first Sands of Time from 2002 that had unique time-bending mechanics, or cel-shaded Magical Prince of Persia from 2008. That is, by the way, one of the most underrated Ubisoft games. For example, Rockstar is also rebooting its settings. Liberty City and from GTA 3 and GTA 4 are completely different places, with different stories and characters. Reboots can sometimes get strange, or publisher decides to use well-known name for completely different game. For example, Syndicate 2012, that changed tactical strategy game into first-person shooter with dubstep and lens flares. Just why, EA? Why? I just saw a video that called Remake of Final Fantasy VII a remaster, so probably ranting about remakes, remasters and other redoing is quite pointless and I wasted everyone's time. So, for the two guys that are still watching, until next video, I'm making one about Vampyr. I will be grateful if you see that next time. Well, and if you like this unhinged rant, try to give me like or something.